Hello, everybody, and welcome to the Top 10 Films of the Year. Sorry my list took so long, but I had to make sure I seek out all the good movies this year. There sure were a lot. Number 10 is Wolf of Wall Street. Oh, I'm sorry, this is 2014. Number 10 is Strange Magic. This is by far the best animated film of the year. Much better than Inside Out and that pretentious drivel Anomalisa. Strange Magic is a brilliant story about love.
Strange Magic is a story about love. The point of the movie is that everyone deserves to be loved.
George Lucas, the genius behind such hit films as the Star Wars prequels, and Howard the Duck made this film, or helped make it, or something. Strange Magic is beautifully animated and has a star-studded cast. Alan Cumming, Evan Rachel Wood, and Tony Cox. He's the voice of Plum Elf. Like, really? The guy's a dwarf, I know, but he has to play fucking dwarves in every animated movie too? Fuck's sake. Like, it's just a voice, you couldn't make him a normal guy. Jupiter Ascending. Jupiter Ascending is one of the most brilliant science fiction films I've seen in years. Unlike that stupid Star Wars movie that just ripped off Akira Kurosawa's Hidden Fortress or something. I think, is that how you pronounce his name? It stars Channing Tatum as Navi, Eddie Redmayne as a former smoker.
Life is an act of consumption.
And Mila Kunis as a former A-list actor. I would say more, but this story is so unpredictable and fresh, you wouldn't want me to spoil anything. So if this seems like a movie for you, I highly recommend leaving the gas on in your garage. Mordecai. Johnny Depp is in it. How could it not be good?
The character of Evelyn is played by, an amazing actress. Rebecca Hall. Who's just so great. Paul Bettany, who's also one of the most brilliant, I mean, just brilliant human beings, you know. And then there's, you know, of course, his work as an actor, which is, you know, I mean, it's, you know, impeccable. I think that this film will force people to ask questions, you know, of themselves and, you know, what they believe, and, you know, how far should any of it go? You know, how far should you allow it to go?
That's all I got to say about that. Paranormal Activity 93, Return of the Fallen Ghost Dimension. This is the best horror film of the year. Much better than that stupid movie with the guy following guys. It is so stupid. The Paranormal Activity premise is much more plausible. It's about ghosts haunting people for no reason. It takes a gimmick that got old years ago and makes it fresh by shooting it in 3D. Even though it doesn't make any sense why they'd have 3D security cameras, but I'm just nitpicking. Gem and the Holograms. Even though the movie has no holograms, it's still a rip-roaring good time full of family fun, laughs, and great music. Fifty Shades of Grey. I was gonna review this movie, but the movie's so boring I didn't. But hey, that's just a nitpick. I always just nitpick movies. The film also has a terrible story, awful actors, a bad script, flat scenes, awful music. Those are all just nitpicks.
It's just beyond this door.
What is? Like your Xbox and stuff?
Fantastic Four! Isn't it funny I made Fantastic Four number 4? I've talked about this film before. And as you know, I gave it a glowing review. It's far from the worst movie I've ever talked about, but still. It's just a disaster. It breaks the conventions of traditional superhero films by focusing less on the exciting and interesting parts of being a superhero, and instead focusing on the boring shit, like people talking, building things, science, driving,
talking, walking,
laying down. Number three is Terminator Genisys, another fantastic Terminator film in the Terminator film franchise. Rather than just make the same movie again, Terminator Genisys decide to establish a universe where everyone has a time machine, and they all time travel all the time as an excuse to tell the same story again. All the performances are just terrific, including Jai Courtney reprising his role as Boring Guy from that great film, A Good Day to Die Hard. Buckle up for a fast-paced adventure that's fun for everyone. It has gotten tons of glowing reviews from both critics and audiences alike. Some asshole on Twitter said, "This movie is great." And film critic Blake Howard from The Movie Show said, "Terminator Genisys is fine." Ball Blart, Mall Blart 2. I can't even pretend to like this one. And the number one film of the year is... Adam Sandler films. Every film that Adam Sandler was in this year was so brilliant, I decided to put all his films at number one. That includes The Cobbler, which is a story about a young man whose father abandons him. Little does he know, whenever he puts on someone else's shoes, he becomes them. This all culminates to a scene where Adam Sandler puts on this guy's shoes and pretends to be him, because this guy has a very attractive wife. Then Adam Sandler tries to have sex with this guy's wife, which is technically rape. Huh. And of course is the film Pixels. Of all the films Adam Sandler was in this year, this is by far his best performance.
The bifocal blaster is here, by the way.
His character is so interesting, and the way Adam Sandler portrays his character, you can tell he really cares about the project. All of the characters and performances are strong here, including Peter Dinklage from the hit show Game of Thrones. In this film, he plays Guy Who Wants a Check. And of course, the final film that Adam Sandler made, Ridiculous 6, which was so good it went straight to Netflix. Boy oh boy, 2015 sure was a great year for movies, but 2016's looking to be an even better year for movies. Can't wait for that great new Zack Snyder film, Batman vs. Superman.
What'd you say? Considering every time your hero says he came out of a tree, you're at a Huffpiece editorial about an alien. Have a bad history with freaks dressed like clowns.
Bruce Wayne meets Clark Kent. I love it.
You're gonna go.
Son of Krypton versus Bat of Gotham.
Man won't kill God.
The devil will do it.
What have you done?
And how could I forget Star Trek Beyond?
Let's hope this doesn't get messy.
Remember King Candy? Well, it's playing on the big screen at the Queens World Film Festival, so if you want to see it, I'll be there. You can get your tickets at queensworldfilmfestival.com. Link is also in the description. It's playing March 17th at 8 o'clock. Hope you're there. If you're in the New York area, New York is pretty big. If you're not New York, then I guess you could take a plane or just not come. But I'll be there, and it's going to be fun. So if you want to come, do. Get your tickets early, because it's going to sell out very soon. Thank you. What's that? I think my roommate's fucking murdered someone in here. I just fucking noticed.